Hi, and welcome to another Digital Anarchy tutorial. I'm Tor Olson, Software QA and Tech Support over here at Digital Anarchy. And in this tutorial, we're going to be going over transcriptive and more specifically how to call for transcriptions once you've logged into your speech engines. First, you need an active sequence, and luckily I have one down here of a goofy little video that Jim and I recorded about the mascots of Digital Anarchy. And when you are calling for a transcription for a single sequence, which we're about to do, you want to make sure you do it with your active sequence. Make sure that it's your active sequence by looking in the list of sequences, and your active sequence is the one that is underlined. So I know I want to call for a transcription for this sequence, so I would go ahead to click transcribe. So from here I'm opening the transcribe dialog for a single sequence. It'll show you the sequence name, it'll show you how long that sequence is, so in other words, how much you're going to be paying for. Over here we can see how many credits we'll be using since we're charging this to Speechmatics. You can select either speech engine by using the transcribe width dropdown. So in this case we have Speechmatics. The information with the engine we're using is shown here in terms of the credits we got, the minutes we can use, how the server on Speechmatics' end is doing, and how heavy a load is on right now. So since there's 0 minutes, we can expect that Speechmatics will come back in about a fifth of the time that it takes for our sequence to play back in real time. And that speed estimate goes into both Speechmatics and Watson. And that amount of time for a transcript to get back to you is what we expect for both speech engines. Speechmatics is a little faster, but only incrementally so. If I were to choose Watson, that information will change a bit. It'll show you the total minutes that I have logged for the current month. So this renews every month, of course, so you get 1,000 free minutes at the beginning of each month. For now, we've only used about 44 minutes here, so our balance due is going to be 0. Once this goes above 1,000, you'll start to see the ticks on your account. So just below where we can select our speech engine, we have the languages that each speech service supports. Each has its unique list of different languages that it supports, with Speechmatics having a little bit longer of a list. We also have speaker diarization, so if you, say, have a sit-down interview and you know that you only have 2 speakers, you can make sure that you limit the speaker identification to 2 speakers. And when you ask for your transcript, you can later take the speaker identification, tweak it if you want, even change the name. So that can be a really useful tool for searching your transcript, maybe looking for one particular speaker or the other. Transcriptive transcripts, by default, come back with every sentence ending in a period. So checking the toggle for identify questions will look for sentences that start with what, why, or certain sentence patterns, and try to associate question marks with those questions. We have an option to align current text, but this is for a different tutorial that we'll go over later. So once we've chosen the speech service that we want to use, in this case I will use Speechmatics, I'll go ahead and click continue, and that will encode all the audio that we have down here and turn into a raw audio file, send it off to Speechmatics. Speechmatics will then create a transcript and return it back to us. All right, so it took about 25 seconds or so. We have a diarized transcript where each individual word has its specific time code, so we can click and you'll notice that the playhead will skip to that portion of the video. Now there are different ways that you can transcribe footage. The method that we use just by hitting the transcribe button up here is to transcribe a single active sequence. But what we can also do is batch transcribe multiple clips or audio at the same time. For that, I would open up the transcriptive dropdown over here, and I can see my batch options here. Now the first one is pretty straightforward. This allows you to select files from your Finder or your File Explorer if you're using Windows. If I were to select that, it'll open up my Finder, where I can then choose some files. So if I wanted to, I could choose maybe 2. A meeting coder is going to open so that the files I just defined are going to be processed in the FLAX that can get sent off to Speechmatics or Watson. So now the meeting coder has sent those FLACs off, we can see the total amount of credits we're going to be using up. We can see how many minutes those collective files are going to take up. And like the transcribe like the ordinary transcribe method, we can see all the same options between Speechmatics and Watson. This time, for just the hell of it, I'm going to choose Watson and go ahead and click continue. And as you can see in the status bar in the upper right hand side of the panel, you can see the progress of the transcription. So you can see we have 1 out of 2 files that are being transcribed, and then the name of the file over here. So those clips are going to process. And in the meantime, I can also go over batch folder and batch project. Batch folder operates in the exact same way as batch files, except that you're obviously selecting a folder instead. Everything otherwise is exactly the same. You're going to see the same queue in your status bar, and Meeting Coder will open beforehand just the same way. Batch project works in exactly the same way, but it's an operation that happens from within Premiere. For that, you would just create a bin, name it Transcriptive with a capital T, and then any files you would place inside of there would then be automatically transcribed when you chose batch project. Now, a really important detail about when you batch transcribe is that the transcript can't be brought out until you put that single clip in its own sequence. If you notice, if I select the clip and go to metadata, in speech analysis, you can see the transcript that we asked for. If I wanted to bring this in the transcriptive, I would bring the clip into its own sequence, go to transcriptive, and from the drop-down menu, you would choose load transcript. That'll automatically pull all the speech analysis information you have in your metadata and display it in the transcriptive panel. This also goes for fully cut sequences. If I wanted to say, trim this down, add a new clip, an entirely new clip, trim that down, maybe even bring in a third clip. I could then go request a new transcript, which completely discards the current transcript I have active. And when I reload, it'll take the collective speech analysis data from all three clips to make one cohesive transcript. This way you can kind of kill two birds with one stone by being able to transcribe all your clips at once, grab transcripts easily from a single cut sequence, and be able to search all your clips for any keywords since you have all that speech analysis data. So those are the two methods of transcribing, either transcribing a singular sequence or batch transcribing multiple files at once. If you want to check out Transcriptive for yourself, you can go to digitalanarchy.com, where we have a demo Transcriptive, as well as a lot of other cool visual effects plugins, like Beautybox, Samurai Sharpen, and Flickr Free. Again, I'm Tor Olson, Software QA and Tech Support over here at Digital Anarchy, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.